So hello students, hope you all are doing well. So in this lecture we will discuss the concept of namespace in C++. Okay, so namespace in C++ acts as a container. Okay, it acts as a container that contains all the identifiers. Okay, variables, etc. Okay, so you can say it is something like this, that it is a container. Okay, it's having a namespace and some name. Okay, it has some name and all the identifiers are grouped inside this particular namespace. Okay, so the main advantage of using namespace in C++ is that it reduces the main thing, that is the name conflict. The name conflict can be avoided by using this concept of namespace. So how this name conflict is avoided in C++, we will just see a scenario. Okay, and on the basis of that scenario we will just understand that what is the use of this namespace, what is the need of this namespace. Okay, so let us say, okay, you have four friends. Okay, you have four friends and all the four friends are developing a particular module. That particular module has to be collaborated into a particular software. Okay, so let us suppose there are four friends that are responsible for maintaining a particular module, such that each module means it is a set of, you can say, instructions that are in a function. Okay, so some modules are to be created and at last these all modules have to be combined in order to make a particular software. Okay, for example, the first friend creates something like this. It creates a variable and it assigns certain value to this variable, and at the same time this particular friend is creating a function. For example, the function is display. Okay, this function display he has created and he has written certain piece of code, certain logic inside this function display. Okay, so the second friend is unaware that his first friend has created certain variable and certain function. Okay, so what he does, he also created a variable of the same name and he assigned certain value to it, and he also created a function of same name because he was unaware that his friend has created this function. But inside this function the business logic is different. Okay, his business logic is different as compared to his first friend. Similarly, the third friend also created a variable. Okay, this might be a case, it is a scenario. Okay, this might be a case, this is a hypothetical case. So the third friend also created a certain variable and assigned a value 40. Okay, and at the same time he also created a variable and named it as this again. Okay, and inside this he has written his own business logic, that is the set of instructions. Again the fourth friend, irrespective of unaware that all the three friends have created the same type of variable, he also created a variable, that is he assigned the value 50, and he also created a function disp, and he has written his own business logic inside this particular code, in this particular region. Okay, so what will happen, now what is the problem, that when all these modules, all these modules will come at a center point, when these all will be at a center, you can say repository, where all these codes have to be combined into a single software, then there is a confusion, there is an ambiguity in the compiler. Because now the compiler, when combine this compile this code, then for the compiler there are different variables. Okay, these are the different variables, but all these variables are of same name. Okay, and all these particular functions are also having the same name irrespective of the logic inside the function. Okay, so the compiler will be in a state of ambiguity. Okay, so now the ambiguity arises. Okay, ambiguity means the confusion. Okay, there is a confusion. Okay, because now the compiler will say that there is a redeclaration for these functions, there is a redeclaration of these variables, because the name of the variables are same in all the modules and the name of the functions are also same in all the modules. So there is a redeclaration for the compiler, because compiler is also, okay, it is also, you can say, a set of instruction that follows a particular protocol. Okay, so according to the protocol of the compiler, okay, if you are declaring same name, then it is a state of confusion that which function it has to be compiled. Okay, which function has to be compiled, there is a confusion. So in order to remove this ambiguity, in order to remove this confusion, so that, okay, we can use all these functions, okay, we can use all these function and we can use all these variables, okay, collectively in our code, in our source code, okay, so that it behaves as a single entity. Okay, so that it behaves as a single entity, what we do, we create a declarative region. Okay, we create a declarative region, and inside this declarative region, okay, so we will create a declarative region, and inside this declarative region, okay, we will declare all the variables and the functions. Okay, so inside this declarative region, what we'll do, we'll just declare all our variables and our functions. So this is the declarative region. Okay, and the name of this declarative region is the namespace. Okay, so now what we are creating the namespace. Okay, so what we have done, we have just created a namespace, okay, followed by some name. For example, it is one. Okay, for friend 1 we have created namespace 1, and inside this what we have created, we have just assigned x equal to 10 and we have created a function void disp. Okay, now this void disp will be a part of this particular namespace that is having certain piece of code. Okay, similarly, okay, for the second friend, okay, similarly for the second friend, we will again create a namespace. Okay, we will again create a namespace, that is 2, and inside this namespace, okay, the second friend can write his variables, okay, having the same name, and create the particular function of the same name. Okay, and he can write the business logic here. So what has happened now, this namespace is independent of this namespace. Okay, because this declarative region for the friend 1, okay, this is for friend 1 and this is for friend 2. So now what it has done, okay, it has grouped in itself, okay, all the variables and all the functions. So the x and this disp function is grouped inside this declarative region, that is namespace 1, and this x and this display, okay, for the friend 2 is kept inside this container or inside this declarative region, that is namespace 2. And this namespace 1 and namespace 2 are independent of each other. Okay, the working of this namespace 1 is different and the working of this namespace is different. Okay, so what we have done, we have created some, okay, set of protocols so that the compiler won't get confused at the time of compiling. Okay, when we are, okay, keeping all the codes, all the modules into a central repository so that it can be combined into a particular software, so that there should not be any confusion, there should not be any ambiguity for the compiler. So here what is the main thing that has been resolved, the name conflict has been resolved now. Okay, the name conflict problem, okay, it has been resolved with the help of namespace. Now you can see, okay, this x is different from this x and this disp is different from this disp, because we have created a separate declaration region for these variables and for these, okay, functions. So at the time of calling, okay, the calling mechanism for this namespace one will be different. Okay, with the help of this namespace one, we can call this disp. Okay, and this disp 2, okay, that belongs to namespace 2 can be called with the help of the namespace that it belongs. Okay, so now we will just see, okay, that how namespace is created. Okay, how we can create a namespace. Okay, and how we can just, okay, you can say how we can use this namespace. Okay, how we can use this namespace in calling the variables and in calling the functions. So first of all, namespace, you can say it is a keyword. Okay, so this namespace, it is a keyword. Okay, this is a keyword, and when we create a namespace, then we create it like that. Namespace, okay, this is the syntax. So this what we are creating a syntax. Namespace, that is the keyword followed by the name of the namespace. Okay, you can give it any name. So for example, if I am giving it as first, so the name of the namespace is first, and inside this, okay, it contains the braces, that is the starting brace and the ending brace, and this is the declarative region. Okay, this namespace, this is the declarative region. So here, this is the declarative region. Inside that, you will declare all your identifiers. Okay, so if I write, for example, void disp here, okay, and if I write something like that, cout, okay, hello. Okay, so when I will call this namespace, okay, so this namespace will be called inside main. Okay, so I will just create a main, and if I call this namespace, then it will be called like that. Okay, the name of the namespace, that is first. Okay, this is the calling mechanism, followed by the scope. Okay, so the scope resolution operator will be there. Okay, that is the colons. Okay, and the name of the function, that is disp. So this is the calling mechanism. Okay, this is how a namespace is used. Okay, namespace is used in calling a function. Okay, in calling a function. So in this way, you can create your namespaces and you can call your namespaces at the same time. So if you have created second namespace, okay, so you will be given, okay, it will be given a name, namespace second, for example. Okay, the name, you can, okay, you can create the same function, that is void disp, inside the namespace second. And how you will create, okay, how you will call it. Okay, for example, I am just creating again a second, okay, namespace, that is, you can say this is namespace second, for example. Okay, for the demonstration purpose, I am just, okay, telling you. And again, inside this, if you have created the function disp, okay, and if you have written, for example, cout, okay, India, if you have written cout India, okay, so now how you will call this disp? Because now in your program, there are two functions having the same name. Okay, there are two functions having the same name, that is namespace, inside first namespace it is disp, and inside second namespace it is also disp. So the calling mechanism is in main. Okay, you will just do, okay, you will just write the name of the namespace, that is first, followed by scope resolution operator and the name of the function that is in the first namespace, that is disp, and second, okay, followed by scope resolution operator, that is, it is providing the scope of this function disp, and it will call the second namespace. Okay, so this is how a namespace is called. So there are certain properties, okay, that the namespace should follow. The namespace, okay, the namespace must be declared globally. Okay, namespace must be declared as a global space. Okay, it must be declared as a global space. So if we are creating the namespaces, so we must declare it as global. Okay, we don't declare the namespace inside a main function. Okay, you must remember it. Okay, एंड वी ऑल्सो ओके वी ऑल्सो डिक्लेयर वी ऑल्सो डिक्लेयर वी कैन ऑल्सो डिक्लेयर ओके वन नेम स्पेस इनसाइड अनदर इट मीन्स nested namespaces can also be there. Nested namespaces can also exist. Okay, but the main thing is it the namespace must be declared in a global space. Okay, we can't create a namespace inside a main function. Okay, so namespace is a keyword. It must be given a name inside the namespace. It is a declarative region that contains a group of identifiers. Okay, so we will just place all the identifiers. Okay, or the functions that we want to use in a program. Okay, so in order to remove the name conflict. Okay, so that there should be no ambiguity. There should be no dilemma to the compiler. We are creating namespaces and we are okay giving the users or the programmers okay a separate declarative region so that he or she can create different okay identifiers of the same name or of different name. Okay, so we'll just see this concept okay practically with the help of a program in a subsequent lecture. Hope it is clear to you now. Thanks.